Welcome, everyone. At this time, the bride and groom respectfully request that you silence your cell phone and please refrain from taking any photos or videos until the ceremony is ended.
Welcome to the wedding, guys!
We'll start. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here today because Andrea and Michael have said to one another, "Honey, I love you so much, we just have to get the government involved." You have discovered each other, made the conscious decision of commitment, and today you step over the threshold into the first day of your officially declared shared life. Not only that, but you're accompanied by witnesses of the best kind. Your friends and family that you've chosen to share this day with are so very special to your journey together. And to you, dearest family members and closest friends, you are the ones who know them well, and you are an important part of this day. Truly, your love and caring fills this ceremony with meaning, and is the same love that weaves a web of ongoing support for Andrea and Michael throughout their marriage. In this way, you make the ceremony more than just a moment in time between two people, but a milestone event to be remembered for years to come. Obviously, as Michael's slightly older, much better looking sister, I have known him for his entire life, and he has not changed one single bit since birth. He is still the biggest pain in the butt, with the most caring, thoughtful heart, and the softest soul of any human being that I've ever known. I remember the first day I met Andrea. It was my birthday. We were planning a night out with family, and Mike says, "I'm bringing someone that I'd like you to meet." And I ask, of course, "Is it serious?" And he says, "Well, I'm bringing her to meet you." We walked into the restaurant, and I noticed right away that Mike's eyes were on no one but Andrea and full with joy. And I'm like, "Wait a minute, it's my birthday. Over here, everybody pay attention to me." But seriously, she seamlessly fit into our family dynamic, and everyone in the room knew this was the real thing. And then Michael went to the restaurant. You remember, Andrea. I grilled her, trying to find a reason that she might not be worthy of my baby brother. Other than the fact that she's a Cowboys fan, I couldn't find her. Now, even though Andrea is much, much older than Michael, their journey has led them to today, August 23rd, 2024, their wedding day. This day falls almost exactly between our favorite brother Tom, raise your hand, Tom, 24th wedding anniversary on August 19th, and my 31st wedding anniversary on August 28th. We hope that being inside this anniversary sandwich, that we have been able to give you the example that when you have love, you truly have everything. At the end of the day, when you're married, you've got someone to come home to, no matter how badly you snore, or how smelly your socks are, or what the universe has decided to drop on your hand. You've got someone to have spaghetti bites in the kitchen with, someone to play ridiculously epic pranks on when the Eagles play the Cowboys, someone to laugh the same silly inside jokes. By now, I'm sure you share your own language. So a few words of wisdom before we get to the good part. In marriage, the little things are the big thing. You are never too old to hold hands, which I can see. Remember to say I love you at least once a day. Speak words of appreciation. Have the capacity to forgive and forget. Give each other the atmosphere to grow. And most importantly, live, laugh, love. The bride and groom have prepared their own vows that they will read now. Andrea? Turns we talked and the hard lessons learned were fewer. But here we are, right on time, the wait is worth it. Our paths never crossed during our high school years of Holy Spirit. Me being a party girl and you a class clown. But there was a silver lining and the diverted path we took because it brought us here today. There were years of football rivalry that still continue today. You later escaped the friend zone that reigned from the friends. Through the last 6 years, we've had highs and lows as we grew together. We have intertwined our lives, and I'm most proud of the greatest little family we created with our two remaining children. We tested our vows early on in sickness and in health, and I knew then I could never live without you. We worked through many challenges in our relationship, and we grew stronger because of it. There was a time in my past that it was tough for me to let my guard down and believe in love, but you changed all that for me. You make love easy and fun. I know life will be full of laughs and never a dull moment. You make me feel protected, and I would do anything for you, and you would do anything for our family. You've made me believe that love can last forever after all. A few promises I make to you today. I promise I will always be an honest and loving woman. I will give 100% and not just my half, especially on the girls. I will always support you and our girls, and I always will try to find the humor behind your pranks and my expense. I stand here today and the rest of my life as your other half. We finally got it right.
Seriously, I stand up here today as the luckiest person ever. Everything you said there, not only did you show me what you can do with love, but just the way it was when I went through my health scare. I wouldn't have gotten through without you. Who would have thought that night at Tailgaters, when I first saw you, that I'd be standing here right now, fulfilling my dream. Your dreams come true to me. They really are. It took a while to get here, but every step I made was worth it. I'm so happy. Andrea, I promise to love you. I promise to be your travel buddy for the rest of our lives. I promise to cherish you. I promise to raise our family the best that I know how. I promise to be your biggest protector. I also promise to try to cure all of your childhood trauma by being a Dallas Cowboys fan. Read that voice. Anyway, I love you. I give my life to you, the rest of ours. You truly are a dream come true. And I promise to treat you like that dream come true for the rest of my life. I love you.
Love, honor, and cherish her, forsaking all others for a woman who goes to others. And Andrea, take Michael, your husband. us to love, honor, and cherish him, forsaking all others for as long as we shall live. Michael and Andrea will now exchange rings as a symbol of love and commitment to each other. Rings are a precious metal. They are often made precious by you wearing them. Your wedding rings are special. They enhance who you are. They mark the beginning of your long journey together. Your wedding ring is a circle, a symbol of love never ending. It is the seal of the vows you have just taken to love each other without end. Andrea, Michael, place the ring on Andrea's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
sign of my love,
that I have chosen you above all else,
above all else,
with this ring I be with.
With this ring I be with.
And Andrea, please place the ring on Michael's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
that
I have chosen you
above all else,
with this ring I be with. It is my great honor and delight to pronounce you husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. and Mrs. Finan, Michael.